Sunan Ibn Majah, authentic hadith book of the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, volume number 4. Sunan Ibn Majah. And this is the message for my mothers, message for parents. They must know where they're sending their children. If they're sending, it's not from me, it's from the hadith and from Quran Majid. That you must know where you're sending your upcoming generation, your youngsters, where, which madrasa you're sending. You're sending that madrasa that instill in the youngsters' heart the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and their belief is according to the Ahlul Sunnat wal Jamaat, that Alhamdulillah is fine. But this is the hadith, my brothers in Islam, of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Hazrat Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, volume number 4 of Sunan Ibn Majah, page number 590, hadith number 3660. So here, my brothers in Islam, Hazrat Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he narrate from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah says, وَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ إِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَتُرْفَعُ دَرَجَتُهُ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. Ordinary people, he will get highest status in Jannat. He will ask, that person, ordinary person like you and me, and our marhumin, the host family marhumin, deceased, they gone, left this world. So they get highest status in Jannat. So after that, Rasulullah says, فَيَقُولُ أَنَّا نِهَازِ, that they will ask in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that, oh Allah, we are in Jannah. Why you gave us highest status in Jannat? More highest status in Jannat, why? So then, my brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reply to them, فَيَقُولُ يَا رَبْ اللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ. They will ask in the court of Allah, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reply to them, بِسْتِغْفَارِ وَلَدِكَ لَكَ. Why I gave you highest status in Jannat? Because you left your good children behind. You left your good children behind. They making maghfirat for you. They making dua-e bakhshish for you. They making the gathering of isale sawab for you. Because of their dua, I gave you higher status in Jannah. Now, my brothers in Islam, this is the word of the hadith mubarak of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ab chalte hain the opposition party imam. What he have to say about isale sawab, Allahu Akbar. This is the student of Ibn Taymiyyah, Ibn Qayyim, a non-Sunni Imam. Ibn Taymiyyah student, Ibn Qayyim, his book is in my hand, Kitab al-Ruh. Allahu Akbar. What he says about Isal al-Sawab of the Marhumeen, that they get the reward in their qabr or not. Here, my brothers in Islam, Allahu Akbar, before we go furthermore, so he says, page number 195, he says, Baaz Biddati kehte hain. Now he is the imam of the opposition party. He says those don't believe in isale sawab, they are the biddatis. They are the biddatis, don't believe in isale sawab. Look at the opposition party imam, he himself calling his people biddati. So furthermore, he says the marhum, he or she left this world when they in their qabr. So they get the reward of the three things. One is sadqa jariya, Allahu Akbar. And then the second, furthermore, he says that knowledge he left behind, that people getting the reward. Now, Alhamdulillah, our leader Sayyidi Mulana Raja Khan Al Qadri alayhi rahma is so lucky. Alhamdulillah, his work is still on. And you still getting the knowledge from Quran and Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So aise hi, my brothers in Islam, this is the second thing. And the third thing he says, same hadith that what I mentioned from Sunan Ibn Majah. He says, if he left his good children behind, so they making dua-e maghfirat, like host family making dua-e maghfirat their marhumin, so they getting reward in their qabr. Today they getting reward in their qabr, my brothers in Islam, because this is the amal and this is the belief of the opposition party. After that, what he says about the isale sawab, he says, Hazrat Saad, the great sahabi of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, man of the battle. When he came back from the battle, his mother passed away. Allahu Akbar. Isliye, my especially youngsters, brothers and sisters, still not too late. Respect your parents. If you want your future must be bright, respect your parents. And if you want your future must be dark, by disrespecting your parents, your future will be dark. So, aise hi, and what kind of parents? Those kind of parents don't tell you, instill in your heart the love of Rasulullah. Those instill in your heart the love of companion Ahlul Bayt Tahar of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and those instill in your heart the love of Awliya, Sultanul Awliya, Huzur Ghaus-e Azam, Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jailani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, those kind of people. So, aise hi, my brothers in Islam, Hazrat Saad came back, and in the area where Hazrat Saad used to stay, Hazrat Saad was the great Alim Deen. He knew Quran and Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when he saw that his mother passed away, same time he ran in the court of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when he came in the court of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, Ya Rasulullah, what I can do that my mother can reward in her qabr? What can I do that my mother get reward in her qabr? So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam could say that, oh Saad, why are you wasting time? Put musalla and read salah. Make ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Rasulullah says, oh Saad, that if you want to send sawab, reward to your mother, then what you should do, you must dig a well. You must dig a water well. And whoever will drink the water from that well, your mother will get reward in her qabr. So this is, my brothers in Islam, a saleh sawab, also non-Sunni imam, also believe. And if he didn't believe, then why he mentioned the hadiths of the Isal-e-Sawab in his book, Kitab al-Ruh? So, yes, status have my brothers in Islam, the Isal-e-Sawab that is allowed from Quran and Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Isliye, my brothers in Islam and my mothers and sisters also, it's very important that today every house is a fight. Why? Because we start thinking whatever is easy for us. We put Quran and Hadith one side. Whatever is easy for us, we start thinking like that. That's why there is no barakat in the business, in the house, in the aulad, in the al, in the mal and aulad. Thus, day we start live our life according to Quran and Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the day we live our life, what we get lesson from the life of Ashab and Ahlul Bayt Tahar of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what lesson we get from the life of Awliya Allah, then from that day our house will be Noor ala Noor. Our aulad will be full of barakat, and the couples, they have the love for each other. Why there is no love, my brothers in Islam? Because we don't have the respect of Awliya Allah. Husband love Huzur Ghaus-e Azam, wife don't believe Huzur Ghaus-e Azam. Alhamdulillah, my brothers in Islam, but the Sunni house is that we love Huzur Ghaus-e Azam also, we love Khwaja Ajmeri also, we love Sabir Pak also, and we love Hazrat Khali Shah also.